Hi, everybody. Jasper Sr. here for this episode of Class Captures, in which I discuss how to calculate percent error. During this class period, I asked my students how old they thought I was to help them learn how to calculate percent error. The formula is up in the upper left-hand corner, and I'm going to go through some of the student responses I got. So one student said 45 years. All right, so we're going to find the difference from the accepted value, which I told is 43. So we do 45 minus 43 in the numerator over 43, which is the accepted value. And we multiply that by 100, and we come up with an answer of 4.65%. So that's pretty close to 43. It was only two away. So we had a low percent error of 4.65. So that was a good close guess. All right. Another example I got from a student, they said 40 years, right? It's on the other side, it's lower than 43. So we've got to switch the numbers around in the numerator because again, we're just finding the difference. There's no set number that you put first. We just need a raw difference, all right? 43 minus 40. And then we put it over the accepted value, which is 43. And we multiply that by 100 and we get 6.9%. So still pretty close, all right? Another good close guess, all right? Meaning that we got a low percent error, okay? Now last year, I had a student who guessed 98 years, and I think they were just joking around, trying to be funny, didn't take it personally. And in fact, it's actually a great example of how to illustrate what a large percent error would be, all right? So we do 98 minus 43, that's 55, and put that over 43. As the accepted value. And then we multiply that by 100, and we get an error of 127%, right? This is a very large error. All right. In fact, the error is bigger than 43. So we actually get more than 100% error. All right. So this was a very, very, a guess that was very off. So if a scientist, in other words, if a scientist got 127% error, they would know to go back and look at where their research is kind of going off from an accepted norm. And then during one class period today, I had one student who guessed 43 years. So I wanted to show you what a 0% error would look like. So that's 43 minus 43 in the numerator. So we have a difference from the accepted value as 0. And anytime you have 0 divided by anything, it's 0. So 0 times 100 is 0. And so this is how it would flow through to get a 0% error. That's exactly the accepted value. So that was an exact guess of my age. And this is how I use my age to help students understand how to calculate percent error. I hope you got some good practice and you learned something from this video. Thanks for watching.